Today, when we snuggle up for a good night's rest, we slide into our memory foam mattresses and polyester pillows. This was not always the case. In the past, mattresses were made of horsehair and straw, and the pillows were filled with feathers. This led to a strange and not commonly known tradition and belief in certain areas of the United States. Death crowns. These delightfully named cushions were given their names after people noticed when those who were seriously ill or had recently died left a circular mass in their pillow. Let's take a dive into this strange and haunting phenomena. Welcome to IF, videos on mystery and history. Hit that subscribe button and ring that bell to never miss a video again. This strange tradition originates in the isolated regions of Missouri, Indiana, and Ohio. It has all but disappeared today, with only a few still following the traditions found in the shadows of the Blue Ridge Mountains. But fortunately, there are still some examples of this practice of collecting the feathered wreaths left behind by the dead in local museums. This tradition of collecting these odd formations of feathers comes from the interpretation that they are a sign from heaven. The feathers of the pillow form themselves into something which resembles a woven wreath, roughly the size of a bird's nest. This is what became known as feather or angel crowns. These were thought to indicate that a person was bound for the heavens, and this was an impression of where a halo would be when they ascended to the afterlife. This omen, belief, or tradition, depending on how you look at it, can be traced back to old Europe with strong ties to the Welsh. These impressive formations were kept as family heirlooms, and great importance was placed on these supposed signs from heaven. Skeptics do have a different opinion, saying that the movements of the sick and dying person, their tossing and turning, combined with the moisture from fever sweats, causing these objects to take form. This tradition was first carried with the people who migrated from the southeastern United States to Indiana. Like many other legends and folk stories, this belief came with them along with their important baggage. Many of this first wave of immigrants settled in the region of the Appalachian Mountains and the surrounding states, many being the forefathers of today's mountain people. Maybe this has you a little worried that next time you put your head down for the night, you may wake to find a death crown in your pillow. If you do, don't panic. An old wives' tale claims that if you break these wreaths up, you prevent the death of the person the pillow belongs to. A collection of these strange oddities can be found at the Lawrence County Museum of History. They have the death crown of a William Kinsner. Kinsner, who was a soldier during the Civil War, enlisting at the age of 14 and dying on January 9, 1936. His widow, wife, donated his crown. The curiosity is a tight coil of feathers about 3 inches wide and nearly 1.5 inches tall. The museum is in possession of a whole collection of death crowns, many of which they display. A Mrs. Olive Brody Jones's crown is the smallest on display. It is approximately 1.75 inches wide and 1.5 inches tall. So before you sleep, or maybe when you wake, just give that pillow a quick inspection. It may well provide you with a warning that today could be your last. Did you know about this strange tradition? What odd beliefs regarding death do people have where you are from? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoy what we do here on the channel, please hit that subscribe button, like, and share. You can find us across social media by searching We Are IF. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.